All right. After seeing the if statement, we are gonna learn switch statement. This is the second statement for selection. If you remember that in if else part, we can have two options to select from. So depending on the condition, we can either do the if part or the else part. So we have two options. But here in switch, it can provide us multi-selection. So we can select not only one of them, but maybe multi-selection is possible and more than two options as well. But here the limitation is that in if condition, we can use any relational operators like less than, greater than, or not equal. But here in switch statement, we can only check if the given condition is equal to the case condition or not. So we have only one relation here, equal or not. Then we can check the conditions according to the case, given cases. If they are equal, we will execute this. And one more limitation is that the expression here, the condition must result with an integer number. So, or char number or character character. Why? Because you know that in ASCII tables, we can automatically convert the character to an integer number. But basically, we are gonna use character. Now, I will show all this in the example. Here, the switch is the keyword. After the switch, we have the parentheses for providing the, let's say, condition. But this time, it's not the condition, but it's the expression, as you know. So this expression must, okay, don't forget, must end up with an integer value. Okay, end up with an integer value. Then here we have the keywords, case, and default. For these keywords, please pay attention that we have some values, variables, let's say. These variables must be integer as well. Okay, all these variables, values must be integer as well, or just the number. For example, you can put the two here. Integer variable or integer. Okay. What we do in that structure, we have the compound statement beginning, ending here. In that compound states, we have the case and integer value. Let's say 1, 2, 3. Let's say here that 2 plus 1 kind of expression. So 2 plus 1 is 3. We have the integer value in the condition. So we are gonna check each case. The case with the value 1 is not equal to 3. 2 is not equal to 3, but 3 is equal to 3. Now we are gonna execute this statement until we come across to break. So break is another keyword here. Break is another keyword. Basically, break means that if you come across to the break statement, what you do is that you are gonna get out of the compound statement and continue with the next statement. Remember that this is the compound statement begins and in previous topic, I said that compound statements, remember, begin and for the compound statements, there will be many simple statements inside, but you might remember the rule. All or non-rule, remember? So it means that if it is the, if you go into the compound statement, you have to do all the simple statements and then exit, or you cannot do any of them and none of them, then continue. So you skip it either. All of the simple statements you can skip and none. But here, now we are learning that we have a keyword break inside a compound statement. If we have the break statement, we can get out of these compound statements. So all or none is the general rule. Here we are doing a partial code execution, right? Partial code execution. How? We are exiting this compound statement at some point. If we have, for example, break here. Now you get out of the loop, compound statement, and continue with the next statement. So that's the idea. Here we have another thing, default. Assume that R is 2 plus 5, which makes 7 this time. And 7 is not equal to 1. 7 is not equal to 2. 7 is not equal to 3. What we are going to do? We are going to do the default option. In the default option, we will have the sum statements. Then we will end of that switch statement. Most of the time we put the default at the end of the cases. Okay. So you compare these result with all possible cases. If they don't match, they are not equal, then you will execute default as default. Any questions?
Hocam bir şey sorayım mı?
İngilizce konuşursa.
Okay, I want to ask if we use break, first of all, we use case value 1. And if it is not correct, then we go to the next one, right?
Yes.
But if it is true, we break out, right?
No, we don't use the break at this time. We only use break if some condition is true. Assume that here is 3.
Okay.
And this is assume that 1, 2, and let's say 5. Okay. Now you compare 3 with case 1. Is it equal to 1?
No.
Is it equal to 2?
No.
Is it equal to 5?
No.
So you are going to do the default and finish. But now let's assume that it is 2. Now the condition is equal to case 1? No.
No.
2? Yes. Yes. Then you are going to execute the statement 1, then break, then go out.
Yes, okay. That was what I was asking.
Okay, but if it's not equal, you cannot go to the any of them.
Yes, okay, okay.
All right. Okay, I will give the details in a moment. That's the basic understanding. Okay, so we have the switch, parentheses, compound statement, case, and here the column, don't forget the column. Column means that this, okay? And we have the values, integer values, and default. And again, after the default, we have the column. And we have the statement, simple statements here. Okay, simple statement means that a statement ending with a semicolon. Okay, this is the general idea. Now I will show you the examples. Okay, let me provide more information here. You would like to determine the life expectancy of a standard light bulb. Okay, and here assume that we put integer watts, let's say, 24. Okay. Now, what's gonna be the output of that program? So I will clear this and this. Okay. Let's go over together. Now we have the variable declaration with initialization. The what is 24? Here is the switch statement. Now, what is the value for watts variable? We know that it is 24. Now, do you think that? Now, let's go over the code again. We have the switch, parentheses, integer expression, compound statement begins, ends here. And let me put here print f by. Okay. Now, do you think that What's equal to 25?
No.
60?
No.
100?
No.
No. So neither these cases equal to given value. So what I am going to do? Default. So default is life 0. Okay, let me do this change here if you like. Let's put the D here and life. So on the screen, what I am going to see?
Zero.
Is it clear so far?
Yes.
Then let's try 25. So this time it is gonna be 25 watts. Do you think case one equals to given value?
Yes.
Yes.
So the life will be now 25 hundredths. Then we have the next statement break. Pay attention. At this break point, I have to go out to compound statement and continue with the next statement. On the screen, I am going to see 25 hundredths. Any questions?
No.
Okay. Let's do another example. Let's say this time, for example, 26. What's going to be the output?
Default.
Zero.
Zero.
Default.
Yeah.
No, output.
Okay.
Zero.
I am asking the output. Okay. Okay. Zero. So let me ask, when it is 60, what's going to be the output?
1,000.
So far, so good. Now, if you understand this simple example, I will make a little bit more complex example. Pay attention now. Assume that I delete this break statement. And we given 25. Now, what's going to be the output?
Nothing.
Output.
Nothing.
Do you think that is it possible? Nothing. There is a printf, right?
Yes.
So is it possible that nothing?
But we couldn't break the switch, so.
So what?
I don't know.
Think about if there is no break.
Continuous?
If there is no break in the class, what we are gonna do? If there is no break in the class, what we are gonna do?
We will continue.
Yeah, so continue.
Okay.
Life is
zero, or I don't know.
No, let's do it together.
Okay. Let's I don't understand now, that one.
What is 25? Okay. Do you think that the value equals to case one or not?
Yes.
Yes.
Now, you are here. Life is now 25 hundredths. Any problem with that?
No.
No.
So do you have any break here?
We don't.
So you have to continue. Now, so life is what? 1,000.
Yes.
Then we have the break. When you have the break, you go out and print 1,000.
Okay.
I got it now.
I understand.
Okay. So okay. It's simple. If there is no break, continue until you see a break. Okay. Let me do the second example for you. Pay attention. For the same example, what's going to be the output?
Seven hundred fifty
will be the result. Everybody sees that?
Yes.
Okay. Actually, it's very simple to see, but I will show you. Okay. Let's do it together. Now it's 25. And 25 is equal to case 1, 25. Now life is assigned with the value 2500. Then there is no break. I will continue life, the next statement, which is 1000. Then there is no break. I will continue life 750. Now I have the break. Now I will go out and print onto the screen 750. So do you understand the importance of break?
Yes.
Yes, teacher.
So how many options I did at the same time for this example? How many options I executed?
Four.
Four or three? Three.
Oh, three.
Yes.
The case
because of the breaks, right?
Already done. Case 25, case 60 done, and case 100 done. So three options is done. So do you understand that the switch is the multi-option, multi-selection? So with 125 value, according to this code, we can execute all of them. Now, I will do one more question for you. Now, if the what is 25, what's going to be the output?
So the third one, I guess.
So what's the output? So what is the output?
750.
Yes, the same output, right? Now, let's continue with this example. Assume that. Now, we have given 25. And 25 equals to case 1. So we are here, but nothing to execute, right? So I have to continue, continue, continue. And life is 750. And we have the break. And we have print 750. In that example, what you notice? In that example, what you notice? Do you think that the what's is 25 or 60 or 100? What is the life expectancy?
Same for all of them, I think.
Yeah, right?
Yes.
Even it is 25 or 60 or 100 watts, the life expectancy always 750. Right? So that's the how we do or using the switch statement. Remember that I said that you can use only the and equal, right? Yes. Now we can implement or by removing the breaks. Any questions?
No, teacher.
No.
Okay. So that's the example that we have solved. Now, if you pay attention to this case statement, if the what is 25, that's part I am going to do, right? If what is 100, I am going to do this. If what is 60, I am going to do this, right? Now, my question is that if what is 40, which part I am going to execute?
1000.
Yes, 1000.
So case 60, right?
Yes.
Yes, case 60 part, yes. I will execute. If case is 40, actually I will execute case 60. Everybody sees that?
Yes.
Yes.
What about case 70? So case... if it is 75, for case 100,
I think.
Which part I am going to actually?
Case 100.
Bravo. Case 100. Bravo. This part. Bravo. Now, can we write this statement in if else statements?
Yes.
How yes. can you? Verbally.
Logical operation.
If case, if what equals to 25, do this else. If what equals to 40 or 60, do this. else if was equals to 75 or 100, do this. Do you agree?
Yes.
Okay, yes. Let me show you. Now you see this, the same idea here. If what is 25, oops, let me see, clear. If what's equals to 25, this part. If what's equal to 40 or 60, this part. As if what's equals to 75 or 100, this part. Look at this, look at this. Which one is easier for you?
First switch case.
Switch case or nested if?
Switch case.
Right? You can read and understand easily, and you can find the errors easily, right?
Okay. Yes.
Yes.
All right. So let's do the same example that we have spent some time. Remember, the customer wants to pay now or later example. Okay. On the right side, remember that our perfect solution is that if the pay code is capital N or lowercase n, he will pay the bill directly. But if it is capital L or the lowercase l, later we apply the interest rate, and so the pay will be increased according to the bill, as we output the payment type is incorrect. Remember that example?
Yes.
Now let's apply this idea also with switch. So we will use the switch case structure to solve the same question. Okay. Here I will explain like that. Now we have the switch keyword. We have the parentheses, don't forget. And we have the begin and end of the compound statement. Then we have the case, these keywords. Don't forget, these are the keywords you have to write. Then we have the default and colon, remember that, everybody remember, colon is that, two dots, okay. And we have the, after the case, we have always columns, okay. And moreover, don't forget that we have to provide the break according to our logic. So far, so good. Now let's check the, here is the statement or the condition is pay code, whatever the pay code. And we know that pay code data type is character, remember? It's character. And we also know that from the ASCII table, we can convert a character automatically to an integer value. Don't forget. But basically in switch statements, you only use integers, not another thing. Not string, not double. Only characters. Okay, but what about this capital N? Do you think that capital N is a character or is an integer?
Character.
Actually, character. So how can we use the capital N here? By using the ASCII table. You have to remember, everybody remembers ASCII table. So we just convert the computer automatically converts a given character to an integer number. Remember, capital A is 65. Anybody remembers? Okay. So do you think that these and these here, if the capital N equals to pay code or lowercase n equals to pay code, we are gonna do this part. Everybody sees that.
Yes.
Yes.
But if the pay code equals to capital L or lowercase l, or we are gonna do all these parts. Can you see this?
Yes.
Yes.
And in both parts, after the all the both parts, please pay attention that we have the break statement, so they will not be confused with each other. And pay attention that if pay code is not equal to n or ll, we need to move to default. And most of the time, this default part is for catching errors. catch error. Okay. Why? Because we are checking that this pay code is not equal to any cases, is not equal to any cases. So we don't expect this value. Am I right? Therefore, we move to the default. And most of the time, default part of the switch case is used for catching errors. If you, for example, four options to enter from the user, then you will provide four cases, one default. So the four cases are expected values to be entered from the user, and the default is for incorrect
catching input. Error.
For catching the error, incorrect input. All right? That's why we use in real life. For example, if you try to create a calculator code, you ask the user what is the arithmetic operation. Let's say four arithmetic operations: addition, subtraction, division, and multiplication. How many options you are expecting? Enter. So addition, multiplication, four operations. But you will use four cases and one default. Let me show you here. Now you will understand better, I believe. For example, I will give this, for example, this is the operation, whatever, maybe inside character, and the case plus something do and break, okay? And the minus for the operation, then do something and the break. And here, for example, the multiplication, do something and break, and division, do something and break. Everybody follows? So don't look inside. And now here in the default, what I am going to write here? You enter invalid operation, right? Because what we expect, the user either enter plus, minus, division, or star character as a operation, right?
Yes.
So we expect four operations. These are the cases, and one default for catching the error. For example, if he enters the, let's say, modulus, and modulus is not expected. So I will conclude the switch statement here. If you have no questions, I will continue with the next topic.